Welcome to this NAG webinar looking at the use of the library for time series modelling. The NAG library contains a range of routines for time series analysis, including univariate analysis with ARIMA and GARCH, multivariate analysis, spectral and cross-spectral analysis, and Kalman filters. For this particular example, we're focusing on autoregressive integrated moving average model, the ARIMA model. This is useful for a very general class of models. It helps understand complex data, predict future data points, and is an essential part of the Box-Jenkins methodology. It's a very flexible method. Let me pass you now to my colleague to go through details.
Thanks, David. I'm about to show an example in Visual Studio how you can do ARIMA modeling. Before I do that, here's a flowchart which describes how it works. So firstly, the user needs to supply some input data, then set ARIMA module parameters. Once it's done, the NAG routines perform the estimation and forecast. After that, the user needs to answer a question, whether the model fit is satisfactory or not. If it's not, we need to go back and set different model parameters, do the estimation and forecast again, and do this until the model fit satisfies our needs. Once it's done, the routine will return output data and the results and finish. The actual data set used in this example comes from US Energy Information Administration, and this is sales and revenue data for electric utilities. There are two NAG routines in use. One is for parameters estimation and one is for forecasting. The example is created in Microsoft Visual Studio 2010. It's written in C# and it uses the NAG library for .NET. Let me switch to Visual Studio. Before that, I can show how the example works. I will select one of the available datasets here and click this button to plot the time series. The blue line are the actual values and the red line are the predictions. I also have actual data for the period of prediction and I can compare them. So I click this button here and I get the actual curve and see that the fit is not really good. So what can I do now? I need to set different ARIMA model parameters to get better fit. Well, I would make an educated guess that there is some seasonality here, and I presume it's 12 months. Here, the seasonal period was set to 5. So I'll set it to 12. Do the process, do the comparison, and I see that the fit is much better. And I can do it with other parameters, so set, for example, the number of non-seasonal AR parameters to a different number, or the moving average parameters, or differencing, and I can do it until I get a fit that would be alright. How it looks underneath in Visual Studio. When I click the button, I firstly read the data from this form, then I declare parameters, I read the values from the form, I allocate memory, and I call the NAG routine which does the estimation. I need to check here whether it has performed correctly. If it has, then I, in the second step, call the NAG forecast routine, which will return the forecast value. I check how it performed, and if it's fine, I return the values, plot the values, and finish. So let me pass back to David. Thank you.
Thank you, Martin. That was very clear. If you have any questions about that example, get in touch with us. We also have an Excel example of using ARIMA, which is extended with spectral analysis. That example has full VBA code and calls to the relevant NAG routines. Again, talk to us when you've looked at that for more details. Bear in mind, NAG routines can be taught from many environments: Excel, VBA, MATLAB, R, Python, Java, .NET languages, Fortran, and so forth. The library now contains well over 1,600 routines. Thank you for your time. Get in touch with us in any way you like.